sir has joined us recently. Before this, he had been heading our Muscat Center, DIT Muscat, for the past 7 to 8 years. So I think I will hand over to Director sir for his words and his welcome to our guests. Director sir.
Yes, madam.
Ji sir.
Good afternoon, everyone. Respected Mr. Singh, Mr. Pathak, Mr. Kamlesh Kumar Singh, my colleagues and students. I feel honored to welcome you all in this power seminar. I'm also thankful and grateful to Ms. Rachna Pratik, Assistant Professor at BIT Noida, and Mr. Singh, Kamlesh Singh, to organizing this wonderful seminar on the industry expectations from or for graduates and postgraduates. Actually, honestly, I have done two research on this topic, similar topic. One was in BIT when I was Noida. I submitted a proposal to University Grants Commission on these qualities or expectations from the B school graduates, and UGC sanctioned a major research project for me. And then another project I did in Oman, same project, but the study was covered in Oman and UAE, Bahrain, Qatar, and other GCC countries. So the topic is very good and wonderful topic, and thanks to the ICD Academy for selecting a very, very good topic. See, primarily, I have many findings, and the findings are validated by PhD Chamber of Commerce, ASSOCHAM, means by their experts, and by UGC and other agency also. Even AICT also say your findings are very good. So, and one more thing I like to mention before start these expectations. These findings are also validated by two industrial sectors or two business sectors. One is banking sector, where I selected my study from five banks: HDFC, RBL, Axis Bank, Kotak Bank, and IDFC Bank, and five IT sector companies like Microsoft, IBM, TCS, Accenture, and Wipro. So my study was 360 degree study, taken consideration by the students, faculty, industry experts, ministry, and associations, and other stakeholders. The first thing I found in these studies from industry expectations from the graduates or for the graduates, three types of skills are most important in these days. First is technical skills that I'll explaining later on. Second is personal skills, personality skills, and third is professional studies or professional skills, ethics, norms, many things are there. And in these days, first thing is every graduate should know the industry standards is continuously increasing or changing. Agility is there, so we have to see that requirement. Like now in these days, digital transformation is the key word, and everywhere all industries are going for digitalization of their business. One thing that I know everybody knowing, every year countless students are passing from different colleges of India, and as per my study or as per various studies, 30% of the graduates are employable and 70% are either unemployed or underemployment. So this is a big gap in this employment and academic inputs. So we have to keep in the mind that this is a big gap, and as per figures information available with me, every year 1.2 means 1.2 million or 12 lakhs are post-graduating from different colleges, and about 5 million means 50 lakhs are graduating from different colleges, technical colleges. I'm talking the technical colleges, not normal colleges. As per these all requirements, few requirements, few expectations which are the mandatory for the graduates or postgraduates. First is and most important is communication and presentation skills. If it is missing, you may be knowing complicated theories, laws, regulations, formulas, everything. But if you cannot communicate to your employer, then you are nowhere. So first skill is communication and personality development skill. Second is knowledge beyond textbooks. Means new ideas, new concepts, innovations. That is most important. Subject knowledge plus domain specific knowledge plus other specialized knowledge is must in these days. So dear students, you please join some free online courses of the top universities, MOOC courses, or like ICT training institutes or some other institutes, or you have to read regularly books, journals and newspapers to update your knowledge. Many times we found the students are not knowing the top world innovators, like few examples of world history on innovations like Walt Disney, Bill Gates, Steve Jobs, or all Indian also like Ratan Tata or Dhirubhai Ambani. They always do things differently or by innovative ideas, not by from books knowledge or something. Third quality is that is a general quality, is a leadership quality. Leadership quality in many interviews, many academic assignments also we judge by the students' academic quality, like organizing the workshops or organizing the seminars or organizing other things or participation in the committees, etc., etc. That is also important. Fourth is also simple, positive thinking and positive approach. So I will not speak on much this. Fifth is very, very important, my expectations as per my study. We have update with the latest technology. Like now in these days, lot of technology is coming, like big data, metadata, AI, artificial intelligence, blockchain, internet of things, cyber security, business analytics, data science, AR, VR, so many things are coming, and those students should get updated, whether it been teach in the classroom or not, but like BIT with the under guidance of our faculty members and training and placement department, we are organizing a lot of webinars, guest lectures, series of seminars, series of experts lectures, etc., etc. So please attend these regularly, these things. Next is students should make a mind, or we should be willingness to travel less traveled roads, new areas, new concepts, new things, new innovation, new startup, not on traditional concepts or not on traditional businesses. They should go with the new businesses. Next is student can also learn some foreign languages if find the opportunities. I saw in the many foreign companies, if you knowing the French, German, Russian, Chinese, you can get value advantages for this. And most important in these days is quality of multitasking. Say, sir, I am in finance, I am in the sales, I do only sales. No, you should know the IT also, you should know the data analysis also, you should know the other marketing areas also, advertising, branding or sales promotion and other things. So multitasking and multi-skilling is very, very important dimension in these days. And next point is fitment and problem solving skills. Every industry, good companies, MNCs, they are looking that whether the student have the knowledge of the problem solving skills or not. And emotional intelligence is also very, very important qualities. Students should be energetic, should be result oriented. Every day, every night, the multinational companies are counting the results of their graduates or the employees. So should be result oriented, should have good analytical thinking, strategic thinking, and many more. And with these expectations, few strengths to be built during the study time, like suppose for BBA student 3 years, MBA student 2 years, they have some strengths that can be developed during their study period, like personality strengths, like their communication skills, their critical thinking, their stable behavior. So many things are there in the personality strengths. and they can also learn lessons from the various case studies, from the business failures, etc., etc. They can learn analytical skills during the study period. Third, professional strengths, the quality and knowledge of the professional bodies, their ethics, their norms, etc., also very, very important. They definitely should be talent mind, talent things, and they should know new patterns of thoughts, new ideas of doing the things. That is very, very important. Team skills, team management, self-motivation and dedication and commitment towards the work. So these are the few things which I observed are very, very important. And last few words in Hindi which I learned from my MBA classes. Every student, every graduate should have josh, zeal, willingness, should have junoon, passion. Passion is the most important aspect in their life. And jagrati, jagrati is basically called awareness, knowledge. You should have knowledge, skills. And last most important is jigyasa, that is search for knowledge, discovery of the knowledge. So these are the very, very important things as per my academic experience with the research. And once again, I thanks to the panel speakers, Madam Rachna Pratik and organizers and my students who have spending their time and attending this program. Thank you very much. Thank you, Madam, and handing over to you again.